So the honeybee population in North Carolina is about average, which is to say that it's pretty bad. On average, colonies across the United States, about 40% of the colonies die off every single year. This year, it's more like 50% in North Carolina, which is not sustainable. And so every single year, beekeepers are trying to grow their populations back from the ones that survive every winter. And so we need to come up with solutions to try to maintain a more stable and reliable managed pollinator community.
As any beekeeper knows, losses are to be expected. There's lots of different stressors, parasites and pathogens, human management and transport, and pesticides and nutrition all play a role in these losses that we observe. By understanding the real impact of exposure and not just focusing on single compounds, we can look at how the holistic exposure environment may interact to threaten honeybees and other pollinators. And by doing this, we can optimize our agricultural systems and improve yields while reducing environmental damage.
So honeybees are important, not just because of the honey that they provide, obviously, but for the pollination service that they impart to about 100 different crops that are grown worldwide.
And it's been estimated that the value added by honeybee pollination is around $15 billion annually.
So the farmers can really help the beekeepers by letting them know when they're spraying, what they're spraying, and try to work with them to minimize the effects of pesticides on bees. The way that homeowners can help beekeepers is to, again, minimize the amount of pesticides that they're spraying in their yards, and also, very importantly, to plant forage for the bees. So having flowering plants that are both producing nectar and pollen, the two food sources of honeybees, can be very beneficial as well.